This is the Money Hour with your host, Tina Mitchell, on Alternative Talk, AM 1150. Now, back to the show with local mortgage and finance expert, Tina Mitchell.
Well, welcome back to the Money Hour with your host and mortgage expert, Tina Mitchell, right here on 1150 AM KKNW, the Saturday, November 29th show. Each week, I share expert advice and inside knowledge on how today's economy and the events in our economy can affect your money. If you're hearing my show at a different time or day, you're listening to a rebroadcast, but you can always call into the show at 1-855-400-1150. Again, that's 1-855-400-1150 or online at themoneyhour.com. And in studio, I have Cheryl Steffen, Sarah Garmire, and Maryann Schuler with Real Living Northwest Realtors. And today we're having a conversation all about Anderson Island. Thank you so much, you guys, for coming all the way over from the island here to studio.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah.
And a little bit of background, a little bit about Cheryl. Cheryl Steffen specializes in properties on beautiful Anderson Island, where she lives and works. She has been in the real estate and mortgage industry since 1997. And one thing that she enjoys most about working as a real estate agent is meeting new people and helping them find what they are looking for on the island, home and property, as well as introducing them to a wonderful community. Cheryl resides with her husband on a 5-acre parcel with all kinds of critters and creatures, which makes no dull moment for her and her husband at all. They've lived on the island for over 10 years, and this makes her a true expert on island life. And also Sarah Garmire. Sarah's part of the Real Living Northwest Realtor tribe. She started in real estate during the crash, so it's been up from there. She volunteers her time with several Anderson Island organizations, Volunteer Island Patrol Member, Historical Society, Gift Store Consigner, Special Event Coordinator, Community Club Member and Helper, Church Organist, First Council of Relief Society. Now that's what she does on her spare time, a little bit of volunteer. Sarah is also a published author, freelance writer, graduate from Film School Screenwriting Program, and she served 14 years in the Coast Guard Reserve and Washington Army National Guard public affairs broadcast journalist. You have had quite the exciting life, Sarah.
I have. There's nothing I haven't tried.
It seems. And now you're here in studio, so yes. It's awesome. And also we have Maryann Schuler with Real Living Northwest Realtors as well. The three of them are all on a team and take care of all of the needs, real estate needs on Anderson Island. Maryann is a property manager with Real Living for long-term rental, vacation rentals, and rentals for the U.S. Open and Anderson Island. She works with Cheryl and Sarah, which are the island realtors. She has 6 years in real estate and combined 29 years in the customer service industry. The island has been a place for her and her family reunion. She's had 3 family reunions there with over 100 family members and 5 generations attending. And now even entered the parade in 2003 as a band of pirates. So it's where her family, her husband and her son now live. And she's learned a little bit of everything out on the island, how to golf and nurture friendships. And so just really excited again to have the three of you in studio. And I just think it's so special that we have an opportunity to talk about Anderson Island. I don't know that it's that I've actually had one show dedicated to a place, but as much time that I've spent out there enjoying time with the three of you, it's an amazing place. And I think people forget the opportunity that they have in investment, and especially when you're purchasing a second home, just having the ability to do it somewhere special and different than here in Seattle, right here in the city life. So let's go ahead and start out and talk a little bit about what makes Anderson Island so unique. Cheryl?
Well, I found Anderson Island to be so unique, just how accessible it is.
Mm-hmm.
Just that 20-minute ferry ride to some of the most beautiful areas, the parks, the people. It's just absolutely amazing. Living on a small farm, we're able to garden.
Yeah.
You know, we can just run across the water there, not run on water, but take the ferry and go to Costco if there's something that we need. It's just very accessible.
Yeah. And I like it whenever I call your voicemail and you're always saying I'm on island. I mean, it really does feel special and unique and like you're on island. Sir, what about you? What is unique and what's so special to you about Anderson Island?
Well, as you read my long list there of things I do in my spare time, it's the volunteer opportunities, because we run the island or it wouldn't happen.
Yes.
And we don't get a lot of services from the mainland, but we do have everything we need on the island. I know we do make the Costco run, but we do have a lovely general store that has a little bit of everything.
You do. It has a shed in the back of the store for everything possible that you need.
If they don't have it, you don't need it.
Exactly.
And they've expanded recently to the rental.
Yes.
For U-Haul and all that.
Oh, nice.
Yes. Yeah.
So we're really self-contained. I rarely leave the island.
Yeah.
I don't like to. Coming up here, driving in this traffic just freaks me out.
Yeah.
And I grew up here. I'm a Seattle native, graduate of Seattle Pacific, and this is where I learned to drive and way back when. So it's just odd that, you know, a traffic jam on Anderson Island is maybe one car and two deer.
Yeah, yes. Literally. And it's so pretty. I mean, just everywhere you drive, you're just driving with trees all around you. It's just gorgeous. Maryann, what about you?
Well, we've been coming out to the island since 1968, and the island is so special. It's a place where we have nurtured a lot of family relationships.
Yes.
And that's what we find. We have a lot of family that have homes on the island. So we try to get together for most of the holidays. 4th of July, like you said, we were in the parade. So we will have like 100 family members on certain occasions.
The Schuler family is the parade.
Yeah. Wow, that's
just
awesome.
So you know.
Yes, my in-laws bought property back in 1968 when they first started coming over to the island by a boat that was captained by Tom Palmer at that time.
Okay.
So they came out to view property and get a set of pots and pans for their trouble. And they did buy a lot that day.
They called that the sucker boat.
Yeah. And how many suckers did it
carry?
And
then they all followed.
Right.
That is awesome. So let's talk a little bit about community. Sarah, unless you've experienced and you've been there, and I can because I have experience, not living there like you guys, I wish I could. Well, my mortgage business is out here and I do this radio show. But anyways, a sense of community. Can you talk about that?
Well, my husband recently had a pacemaker installed, and I had to be gone the next day afterward. And I just made one phone call, and two people came in shifts to sit with him. It wasn't that he needed nursing care, but he was still pretty well drugged up the next day after surgery. So it's that kind of community. Nobody questions it. They didn't, you know, like, what's in it for me? What goes around comes around.
Yeah.
And we'll all take our turn.
Yeah, that's awesome. Cheryl, what do you experience? I mean, because you've been there the longest out of the three of you, right?
Yeah, I think Sarah and I are neck and neck.
About the same.
Yeah? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So what do you experience with the community?
People are friendly. When you're driving around, everybody waves. They'll look at you funny if you don't wave. They know your car. But just how everybody comes together, for instance, when there's a storm, people will bring blankets. We have a call list. People will check on the elderly. Just pull it all together and make sure everybody's taken care of.
Nice. That's beautiful. Maryann, anything?
Basically, it's what the two other gals said. It's just a real friendly community. You can just send out a message on Facebook and people are responding to you. I've got that. I'll bring it right over to you. So it's the Facebook thing is really a real good communication tool on the island for people.
Yeah, when
people
the power goes out.
Yes.
Yes, exactly. So what about one thing, Maryann, one thing that attracted you to Anderson Island?
The parks.
Okay.
All the different boating activities, the fishing, all of that.
So just all of the outdoors activity.
All the outdoor activities there. And it was so close to home. You didn't have to travel 2 hours to get there.
Yeah, that makes total sense.
It was within an hour of our home. We lived up in Edmonds.
Okay.
And so it's easy to get there.
Yes. Sarah, what about you? Number one reason that you're on Anderson Island.
The security.
Okay.
And I won't say that we don't lock our cars or our houses or anything, because I'm not going to say that. But if someone were to take something, where are they going to go?
They go to the
ferry lane, and then and their camera's there, and you just have to go down there and find them and say.
So you feel safe on the island.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. Yep. Cheryl, what about you? One reason you and Eric went to the island.
Really, the serenity, having that open space for us to garden, and we're just left alone. We're a phone call away from our neighbors.
Yep.
But we just had that wonderful place to call home, and and do what we want to do.
Yeah, and those are really good reasons. If you're listening right now, the show is about Anderson Island and then the uniqueness of it and the opportunity on the real estate. I've got three real estate agents here that represent and on Anderson Island and really run most of the real estate that's out there. And it's just a great opportunity if you're looking at retiring and you want to go to a unique, quiet community place. Anderson Island is a really good place to look into, or if you're looking at a second home or investment property. So Cheryl, how did you develop your business and making it in unique? Because it's unique that you sell real estate on Anderson Island. I mean, it's not like people that sell real estate here and they're just going all over to these different areas. But so how did you make you unique and your business unique in a unique environment?
Well, first I have to say my mother always wanted me to be a realtor, and I became a mortgage broker back in 1997. And I said, that's as close as I'm going to get. I don't want to work those realtor hours. But a good friend of mine, Pat Laguna, retired in 2006, and she convinced me to take over her book of business.
Mm-hmm.
And so I started working it. And then about a year later, I met Denise Lones at the EdCon.
Amazing speaker. Yep, I've had her in studio quite a few times.
And she, we just really connected, and I went through her programs, and she mm-hmm. mentored me and helped me develop my branding. Uh-huh. And it just worked really, really well. And plus, I love people, and I love to see the results, the whole process, but the results is what I really
okay.
like.
Okay. And Sarah, how does your market on Anderson Island compare with the Pierce County? So, and what's happening on Anderson Island versus Pierce County? What are you guys seeing?
We're so very different. The mainland, and I do help islanders when they're moving from the island.
Okay.
Find homes on the mainland. So I have worked in that market.
Okay.
And that market is a lot faster.
Yes.
If you don't get your offer in quickly, things disappear. We are a little slower.
Okay.
So we got some time.
So you have more than 5 or 10 minutes to make a decision if you actually want to write the offer. Okay.
Yeah.
That's
And I work with mainland realtors who come over, you know, with their clients.
Uh-huh.
And the first thing I have to say is you've got to slow down.
Yeah. Wow.
You know, we can't get contractors over here immediately to do the furnace filter or whatever it is that they find in the home inspection process.
Okay.
So I say, just, it'll get done. Just relax.
Okay. Yeah. That makes total sense. And on that note, because I've got to take it to commercial for a second, Sarah, but is there unique things that are, when it comes to putting that real estate transaction together, that you're seeing property more on Anderson Island that maybe is a caution to look out for and to make sure that you're getting that addressed? Anything that you see that's different, or is it the same things as what we would see here in our market?
Cheryl, property. Have you? What are you?
More septics going on out there,
Really, the septic thing. People are surprised with the septic process because it costs more.
Okay. Okay.
And just a little more time to coordinate and get all that done. Other than that, and doing transactions off island, it seemed to be very similar.
Yeah. Okay.
But we know all the little tricks to get things done
of course.
On the island.
Of course. So again, if you want more information, if you've got a little thought, maybe that island life might be good for me, pick up the phone, give the show a call at 1-855-400-1150, 1-855-400-1150, and I will connect you with my guest that I have in studio, or you can go on to themoneyhour.com and ask any question that you may have for them. And coming up next on the Money Hour, do you want to learn about a great place to purchase your second home? We're going to continue our conversation. Everything on Anderson Island, Cheryl Steffen, Sarah Garmire, and Maryann Schuler with Real Living Northwest Realtors. Today's show's about Anderson Island. Right here at 1150 AM KKNW after this short break.
This is the Money Hour with your host, Tina Mitchell, on Alternative Talk, AM 1150. Now, back to the show with local mortgage and finance expert, Tina Mitchell.
Welcome back to the Money Hour with your host and mortgage expert, Tina Mitchell, right here on 1150 AM at KKNW, the Saturday, November 29th show. I'm dedicated to my listeners, providing you with tools needed to make informed decisions on matters when it affects your money. If you're hearing my show at a different time or day, you're listening to a rebroadcast, and you can call into the show to talk with any of my guests at 1-855-411-50. I can connect you directly with any of them or online at themoneyhour.com. And in studio right now, we're coming came back with Cheryl Steffen, Sarah Garmire, and Maryann Schuler with Real Living Northwest Realtors. Today, we're discussing the opportunities in real estate on Anderson Island. Thanks, you guys, for hanging out with me for the entire show here. This is just awesome.
It is.
Maryann, I want to go ahead and just start with you and talk a little bit about, because you do a lot of, there's a lot of rental properties, a lot of renting happening on Anderson Island. And how is the rental market out on the island?
Actually, it's pretty good, Tina. Okay. We're getting calls every day for putting homes on the market and for people that want to find a rental.
Anything unique that's happening in the rental market in the arena out on the island different than here?
It can be a little difficult to find a renter because of the ferry schedule.
So there's some opportunities, and if people are not concerned about dealing with the ferry schedule, then there are some really real opportunities for them to be able to get a reasonable rent, because you're not seeing the lack of inventory as we are here.
Right. And the prices for rent on the island are a lot less than on the mainland. So that's what is attracting people to the island.
Yes. So it's just having a little, you've got to prepare a little bit more than maybe, I mean, you've got to think ahead and you've got to be on time. But other than that, there's, you know, if you can do that, it's a great opportunity and not really that big of an inconvenience. The ferry comes and goes, plenty of opportunities. You just have to kind of plan around it.
Right. And I think it's going to get better here next year.
Uh-huh.
They are going to be voting on putting an earlier ferry on.
Okay. So what's the ferry schedule right now, Maryann?
The first ferry leaves at 6:15 a.m. from the island.
And then the last one?
It differs.
Oh, okay.
It could be 7:30 during the week.
Uh-huh.
Till Thursday, then it's 8:40. Friday and Saturday, it's 10 o'clock.
Got
it. Friday is 11.
During certain parts of the year.
Oh, okay.
That's in the summer.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah. So it differs all the time. But with the earlier ferry that they're planning, it would leave Steilacoom at 4:45,
mm-hmm.
and get over to the island at 5:15.
Okay, yeah, not bad at all.
So that would really help the rental market, because people could get to work early enough, like people from Fort Lewis.
Yes. Okay.
We're very near there, very near.
Very near, mm-hmm. and they cannot get to work with the ferry on time now because they have to be to PT duty at 6:30 in the morning. So that's alleviating a lot of the people that would want to move out to the island.
Yeah, makes sense. So if you've got a later shift, then not an issue. But if you're coming in that early, yeah. So Sarah, are real estate sales improving on the island, such as numbers of homes selling and medium price? So what is your medium price and what are you seeing happen in on the island in the real estate sales?
In the cabins that we have are very, very reasonable. Mm-hmm. They can be close to $100,000 to $200,000.
Wow.
Yeah, so a second home is very doable for a lot of people. One thing that was, when Maryann was speaking, I wanted to comment on, is that we see a lot of growth in people who work from home. They can be any place in the world.
And a lot of people, that's it, yeah.
And they are choosing to live on our little green island because it's a beautiful place.
Yes. And Cheryl talked about the serenity of it, mm-hmm. and it just really, I mean, if you do work from home, what a more beautiful place to be able to work from home than on Anderson Island. And I know Cheryl and your, I mean, you guys have an office, you've got a house there that's been made into a real estate office, but each of you have spaces in your house as well. And you know, and Cheryl, I've been to your office many times, and it's just beautiful to be able to work right where you're at, have all your farm animals out there, and
absolutely.
How inspiring.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what about the favorite parts of living on the island? Cheryl, what is your most favorite part?
Oh my goodness, I have to pick one. You know, going back to the serenity,
mm-hmm.
While I'm working, I can push away from the desk and just get out and go for a walk no matter what the weather is.
Yeah.
You're not going to get run over by a car. Great place to ride bikes.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, that's how I found the island. I was bike riding and
Steilacoom.
Uh-huh.
Excited to take the ferry over to the island, yes.
Yeah, you just have so much relaxation. When you take the ferry from the mainland to the island, mm-hmm. it's like a switch goes off.
Yeah.
And you go into this whole other mode of relaxation.
Yeah, that's totally true. Sarah, I know you talked about the security and just feeling really safe out on the island. Anything else that is just, you know, I mean, you and Bob, that's your home, you're going to be there.
Mm-hmm.
And so what are some other special things?
It's so quiet. And we have the animals, the deer and the raccoons and coyotes.
Uh-huh.
And some people don't like the coyotes, but I kind of think they're a necessary part of the ecosystem.
The bear.
As long as they they're not eating your chicken.
Well, but the coyotes were there first.
Yeah, okay.
You know, they got to make
Sarah.
A living. Yeah.
Okay, all right.
And we do have one bear that comes from the mainland over on Long Branch, swims from the pit passage to McNeil, and then once in a while comes over toward across Balch Passage, which is narrower, onto the island. He's looking for love.
Oh my gosh, how fun.
But he doesn't find it, so eventually he goes back home again.
Yeah, oh my God, how awesome. Yeah.
He finds blueberries.
Yeah,
or blackberries. That's
huckleberry.
Huckleberries.
So have you guys gotten too close to the pet bear that's coming over?
No, never seen it.
Maryann, so you talked about just the lifestyle living, you know, outside all the activities. Anything else that that's just very special to you about Anderson Island?
Well, I love waking up every morning to the view that I have of Mount Rainier. And that is so special to be where we're at and just to see the different views of that mountain.
Yeah, it is gorgeous out there. So, Maryann, what portion of the homes that you lease out are you providing property management services to?
I would say about 70%.
Okay, wow, and that's surprising. And that's, I mean, it's good. People should use property management because it makes life so much easier. But actually, that doesn't, because a lot of those are, they're not living on the island, so it makes more sense that they definitely need to have a... Right?
Right. A bunch of them are from out of state.
Okay.
Owners, so, you know, it's feasible for them to have
sure.
a property manager to come winterize their house or just check on it and, you know, to collect the rent.
Sure. Makes total sense.
Yeah.
So, Cheryl, what's coming up in the near future that may have an effect on the island?
Well, we do have the U.S. Open, and I really want to let Maryann talk about that because that's kind of her pet project.
Maryann?
Yes, the U.S. Open is coming up next June, and it's really a big deal. Right now, I say, well, that's one. I'd have close to 20 houses that are for rent on the island for the Open, and most of those are permanent residences. At which they are going to rent out their house for that specific week.
So they're gonna vacate their home for the opportunity to be able to rent the property.
Right.
So what's the what would be an average cost associated to renting?
Well, I think the lowest right now ones that I have are about $1,200 a night.
Okay, and I mean if you're gonna go to the U.S. Open, what an amazing thing to be able to spend some time on Anderson Island. So what is it going to be like with the commute and from the island for the U.S. Open?
Several of us are working on a transportation plan, Maryann especially.
So what's happening with that, Maryann?
Well, right now what they can do is park their car at the parking lot at the ferry. Walk on the ferry
over at Steilacoom.
Take your 20-minute take your 20-minute ride across to Steilacoom. Catch a Pierce County Transit
shuttle
at the
bus.
Dock,
okay,
which will take you up to Fort Steilacoom, which will be our closest shuttle. That's about, a mile up the road?
Yeah, not far.
And you'll be dropped off there, and you will catch a specific shuttle bus that will take you to the U.S. Open.
Which is, 3 miles away from
3 miles away from our dock.
Wow.
Yeah. No one will be able to travel on Grandview, which is the road that Chambers Bay Golf Course is on, except for golfers, the shuttles, and naturally the people that live in that vicinity. That's why everybody's going to have to catch a shuttle. Mm-hmm. And we're very close to the parking lot where our shuttle will be. Now, the other parking lot that they're talking about is at the fairgrounds in Puyallup, which is like a 17-mile drive. So I'd say for a 20-minute ferry ride and a 3-mile drive, Anderson Island would be a good choice of a place to stay.
So if you're listening, you're thinking of going to the U.S. Open and you want to have a nice place to stay, make a vacation out of it, spend some time on the island, pick up the phone, give the show a call, 1-855-411-50. Again, that's 1-855-411-50. Maryann, what website can they go to as well if they just want to go directly to you?
AndersonIslandRentals.com.
That's pretty easy. AndersonIslandRentals.com, and find out and get more information about the memories that you can build around the U.S. Open and your experience and your time on Anderson Island.
There's actually quite a bit to do on the island for the non-golfers in the family.
Okay, so go ahead and talk about that,
Sarah.
We've got
a wonderful swimming beach in a lake, the old swimming hole, Lowell Johnson Park. We have rental mopeds and bicycles coming to the new rental center.
Yeah.
We have kayaks.
Yeah, the kayaking. Yeah, I did kayaking as
of course.
Oh, of course. Mm-hmm. We have our own 9-hole golf course.
Okay.
Right there. We have a lovely restaurant. A lovely restaurant. Yes, you heard me right. There is one.
Right, one restaurant. It's so beautiful.
Yeah. And there's lots of parks on the island for people to hike on.
Can you horseback? Oh. Can you get horseback there on the island?
People own horses, but...
Yeah, but there's not a... Okay. No? Okay. So kayaking, golfing...
Fishing.
Oh, yeah. Bicycle, mopeds.
Mm-hmm. The hiking trails, I have to tell you, my husband and I have hiked most of them.
Uh-huh.
And they are absolutely amazing. And they're not really advanced. So, you know, anybody could really hike through there.
Okay.
Yeah.
We've got a brand new park we're so proud of, the Jacobs Point Park. It's, how many acres is that? 600 or something? It's it's large.
Oh, boy.
And it's on salt water. And they're just now, we just dedicated it in the last 6 months. And they're busy building trails out to the beach.
Okay.
And
they'll have picnic tables out there too.
Yeah.
So do you guys think with the U.S. Open that that's going to have an effect as far as the sales in the month of June?
You know, that is a huge, you know, I have a palmist, like a fortune teller's
of
hand.
Well, I know you do, Sarah. That's why I'm looking right at you.
And when people ask that, I say, talk to the hand. We do not forecast the future as much as we would like to.
Yeah. Well, I think afterwards, it's especially with the word that's getting out that there's this opportunity. I think a lot, I don't know, but I didn't really know about Anderson Island until I met you guys. And so I think there's probably a lot of people that don't. And this is getting an opportunity to get the word out. And when people are staying there, which this is happening, I think that they're just like you, Cheryl. You just happened to cross it and took a little ferry ride to see what was over there. And then you and Eric moved there.
We fell in love.
Yeah, and I've heard a couple, quite a few people that have made it out to that live on the island. It's kind of that's their story. So my crystal ball in my hand is saying that your real estate market's going to see some benefit after this U.S. Open.
We hope so.
Yes. Again, any information that you want to get on the opportunity on Anderson Island, pick up the phone 1-855-411-50. Again, 1-855-411-50. It might be a good idea to buy that second home now before the U.S. Open, just in case my crystal ball happens to be right.
Absolutely.
Take advantage of the market while it's there. Coming up next on the Money Hour, we're going to continue our conversation about real estate investment opportunities on Anderson Island with Cheryl Steffen, Sarah Garmire, and Maryann Schuler with Real Living Northwest Realtors right here on 1150 AM KKNW after this short break.
This is the Money Hour with your host, Tina Mitchell, on Alternative Talk, AM 1150. Now, back to the show with local mortgage and finance expert, Tina Mitchell.
Welcome back to the Money Hour with your host and mortgage expert, Tina Mitchell, right here on 1150 AM KKNW, the Saturday, November 29th show. I built a network of elite industry professionals every week sharing their knowledge and expertise to my listeners. And if you're hearing my show at a different time or day, you're listening to a rebroadcast, you can always call into the show at 1-855-411-50. Again, 1-855-411-50 or online at themoneyhour.com. And back in studio again, had for the entire show today to talk about Anderson Island. I have Cheryl Steffen, Sarah Garmire, and Maryann Schuler with Real Living Northwest Realtors. Again, the conversation on Anderson Island and our real estate experts. So I took it to commercial, we were talking about the U.S. Open and the opportunity for rental properties for people to go out and rent for a night, two nights, or however long that they'd want to stay while enjoying the U.S. Open. And, you know, kind of just a new introduction to Anderson Island and what it has to share. What do you think things are going to be like out on the island during the U.S.? I mean, have you anticipate how many rentals that you're going to be But renting for the U.S. Opens or not yet, Maryann?
It's really hard to say how many will rent. When I went to a meeting in University Place a couple of months ago, and Danny Sink, who works for the USGA, was there giving this meeting to the whole University Place population that came to the meeting. He said, don't expect for everybody to rent your homes.
Sure.
So, you know, not everybody who has a house up for rent is going to get it rented.
Makes total sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And so, Sarah, what's the direction that you would like to see the community go on Anderson Island? Are you, you know, are you excited to see things change and grow, or would you prefer just to have them remain the same?
It's the history of the island is that we didn't get electrical service until 1961.
Wow.
They didn't want it. They had generators. They and then they didn't
really?
And they didn't even really want telephone service. Other
so they
than
really just
the
wanted to be out
party line
on an
they
island.
Had.
Okay.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
So there when it
and
went
could you
from
see
a,
being out there without telephone and without
not me
not
no,
too much.
No,
okay,
no.
Yeah.
But the ferry went from a 6-car ferry to a 9-car ferry.
Okay.
And then
18.
What? 18 and then 30 something?
32.
32.
Okay.
And now we've got a 54-car ferry. So capacities on the ferry are growing.
Of course.
More runs. When I first lived out there, I first moved there in 2000, the ferry stopped running at 6 o'clock at night.
Yeah.
So there were very few opportunities to actually get to a job that ended at 5 o'clock and get back home again.
Got it.
So now that it went to 7:30, that opened up many more miles you could go to get. But we can't quite still get to Seattle, to this market, where there are better jobs.
Okay.
You can get as far as Federal Way, Kent, south to Olympia and beyond that. So, of course,
So to have some change maybe in continued growth with the ferry and the expansion of those hours would be appealing.
That
to
is
you.
The bottleneck, is
okay.
that ferry.
Okay.
So
or is there anything that you wouldn't like to see, Sarah, that you're hearing that it, you know, they might be adding or growing too much, that it's something that would take away from the island life, or no?
If we ever get a McDonald's or a Walmart, I'm leaving.
That makes total sense. Makes
Ditto
total
that.
Sense. Well, you never know.
Oh no.
Cheryl, what about you? Are there things that you would like to see and continue to grow, or how would you like to see the island change or not change?
Well, if it could just stay stable with just an easy growth, which it has. You know, we need a certain amount of tax base to pay for things for our roads and services. I don't want to see an explosion.
Yep.
Definitely don't want the McDonald's or the 7-Eleven, but just enough to support our base there.
Yeah. So to continue the growth of the island and make sure that everyone has what they need, but not too much growth that it takes away from island life.
Yeah. And opening up the ferry schedule a bit so that we can offer housing for some of the military families, I think would be great, because we get a lot of calls from the military families.
Yeah.
And then they realize that they can't.
And that's too bad, because with the community and being able to support for the military families would just be a beautiful place for them.
Absolutely.
Maryann, what about you?
Well, I agree with both Cheryl and Sarah on that. And the island does have to grow some, but not a lot. Like Cheryl said, to support the tax basis and to improve our property values, we need a certain amount of people moving over there.
Sure.
So that's what we're hoping
for. Do any of
you
know what the percentage of people that are actually full-time that live on the island versus rental or second homes? Is it like a 50-50 or, you know, any idea?
We have two distinct areas of residents on the island. One is called the Riviera Community Club, and that is a homeowners association. They provide water for your dues, plus all their little private parks.
And you guys are part of that?
I am.
Maryann lives in the Riviera.
Okay.
Cheryl and I do not.
We're
on acreage.
Okay.
So beyond, about a third of the island is Riviera, and beyond that is unincorporated Pierce County, which would be acreage.
Okay.
And you have to have your own well out there, but in the Riviera you don't.
Okay.
They have water service in Riviera. So most of what we're talking about are Riviera homes. They are on about a 1/5 acre lot.
Okay.
And there are services there, you know, for like the water.
Mm-hmm.
And then outside of that is our, where we live, unincorporated area.
Yeah. And you guys have beautiful properties mm-hmm. and homes out on the island. Now, Cheryl, can you talk a little bit about the new, what are they calling those, the little homes that are, because that seems mm-hmm. really exciting and a really great opportunity if you can't afford, you know, a $200,000-$300,000 home. There's some real opportunity. Can you share that with my listeners?
Yes, it's not set in stone yet, but okay. we're working at getting approval to open up the ability to put microhomes.
And explain what a microhome is.
Well, I don't know the exact criteria, but uh-huh. The ones that we're looking at mm-hmm. are about 300-400 square feet.
Okay.
And those could be placed theoretically on the Riviera lot and have the water mm-hmm. and septic hooked up.
Uh-huh.
Have a little outbuilding, a garage, and it'd be an affordable second home.
And a real opportunity for a little community within those mm-hmm. those properties there.
Yeah, absolutely. And very, very affordable. Uh-huh. So that's what we're working with the Riviera management and the board. It'll have to go out to a vote to the
okay.
membership.
Right, it's funny,
right,
as soon
now
as I heard
a restriction against
oh,
it.
Okay,
homes have
what's,
to be
what's the reason
at least
for that?
1,000 square feet. Well,
okay.
We didn't want park model trailers
okay.
that don't look so nice and appealing after 10 years.
Got it.
Because this is
so you're concerned about if there's not control there, that it could bring the value down on the island for,
exactly.
for residents, full-time residents. Okay.
Exactly.
Yeah, and as soon as I heard about the what are the micro properties?
Tiny homes.
Yeah, the tiny homes. I was at the home show doing a tour around, and I saw one of them, and it was adorable. It was very, very pretty.
Great second home. It really
yes,
would.
Yes. So what about any challenges? I mean, we've talked, it seems like the biggest challenge is just dealing with the inconvenience of the ferry schedule. But I think it's around planning. Unless and I wasn't really thinking, Sarah, that, you know, if you'd work in downtown Seattle, there really is no planning. You just can't make it happen. Mm-hmm. But, you know, other than that, are there any other challenges that you deal with on the island life?
Well, as I mentioned about the people working from home, they want
okay.
high-speed internet.
Okay, yep.
And we are served by CenturyLink. Can I say that online? That's our only telephone system. They provide mm-hmm. DSL service. And we are very rural, and there are a few of us. What's the full-time population? 2,000?
Oh, full-time?
I think it's a little less than 2,000.
Even less than that?
1,400.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So we're not top priority with them
uh-huh.
because we're a small market for them.
Mm-hmm.
But that seems to be one of the criteria that people are looking for. If
okay.
they're going to work from home, they want the high-speed internet, and it's not there.
All right. So I communicate back and forth with all of you. I mean, I work with a lot of your buyers out on the island, and I've never experienced any. Is it just a matter of, it's just not that split second, but
yes.
I mean, you're getting things done and
absolutely
you're, yeah it's
I
just,
send files, photos all
yes.
the time. There's
yeah.
no, I have no problem. It may be slower,
sure,
but it's the whole pace of the island, so it fits right in.
Exactly. That yeah. it is a slower life. Mm-hmm. Maryann, what about you? Any other challenges outside of not having that instant?
Well, what I was going to say about uh-huh. the internet, a friend of mine was trying to download some video that was taken yesterday of the whales out in front of Anderson Island.
Okay.
And it took him 6 hours to download
oh,
that
dear.
So he could get it to Channel 13.
No way.
Yes.
Mm.
That's how, yes.
You didn't call me?
I put it on Facebook.
Okay, so I'm the Luddite in the group. I do not do Facebook.
Yeah. So there's always pros and cons, and the pros is just being out in a quiet community, beautiful island, but some of the cons is just, you know, dealing with a little slower service and dealing with the ferry schedule. And another con, or another pro, is the ability of the great real estate opportunity that you have mm-hmm. price-wise. And sometimes I'm talking a lot about second home purchase today because I just think it's so perfect. And I would like to get a second home out on Anderson Island. And if you think you might not be able to afford a second home and you're thinking out here and in the Seattle market, there's some really great opportunities. So Sarah, I understand that vacant lots in the Riviera Community Club are a real bargain.
Oh,
so
goodness.
let's talk about the bargain for my listeners.
You want the whole history on this and why they're such a bargain right
sure,
now?
Sure. Yeah. Let's go for it.
6 or 7 years ago, some of you may have seen on late night TV, Eric Estrada from Chips, of course, yes, with his pearly whites. It was advertised in this market briefly, but mostly the company that came in and purchased a lot of the lots, that's silly, several of these parcels, marketed it in California and on the East Coast, Florida, okay, Georgia, and people came in and bought the lots for $20,000 to $40,000.
Okay.
Now, compared to their market in those areas, it seemed like a bargain.
Sure.
And I feel badly that they didn't do their homework ahead of time to realize that the lots were selling for between $4,000 and $8,000.
You've got to be kidding me.
But based on properties in Florida and California, Georgia, they look like a big bargain here.
Okay.
So then the people who purchased got their assessments from the county showing that the lot had been worth $4,000 to $8,000, and they got pretty upset about it. Several of them just stopped paying the company.
Okay, all right.
So now we are a good 3 years past that, and those who stopped paying the Riviera dues, stopped paying the company for the property, they were recently on auction this last week,
uh-huh,
with the county foreclosure. So people who are trying to sell a lot competing with the county foreclosure costs, prices.
Or whatever, yeah.
Yeah, so that's why people want to get out from under their Riviera lot.
Got it.
Paying their assessments and their taxes, or dumping them for between $2,000 and $3,000.
Wow.
And so here's a huge opportunity.
Yes.
It's a huge opportunity.
Yeah, and so that is an amazing opportunity. Now you actually have to put something on. You don't have to put anything on the lot.
You don't have to put anything on the lot.
Okay.
No?
Okay.
Come down and enjoy the amenities.
Yeah, wow.
Or eventually build.
Mm-hmm.
But you can't camp on them.
That's
can't
true.
Can't camp on them. No, okay.
These are residential building lots.
Yes.
They're not camping.
Yeah, so you're protecting the integrity of the island.
Absolutely.
Obviously, which is great. What about long-term rentals? So if there's a, you know, we talked about the opportunity to rent for the U.S. Open, so you're going to come over there for a few days or whatever. What about long-term rentals?
Actually,
Maryann,
the long-term rentals are going pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
I've been renting quite a few recently, and I still have 3 long-term rentals that we need to find tenants for.
Okay.
So, that's all?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Yeah. We have a beautiful log cabin. Big log cabin, 2-car garage.
And how much is that log cabin, Cheryl?
Oh, it's just $1,375 a month, and it's on a...
Three parcels.
Three parcels, so almost 3/4 acre. And it has a koi pond.
Yeah.
Just beautiful. 2 master suites, 1 up, 1 down.
You've got to be kidding me. For $1,375 a month. Unbelievable.
Yeah, what would that be on the mainland?
Oh, geez.
$2,500? You know,
probably.
Double.
Probably.
Yeah, I would think at least that. Mm-hmm. So if you're looking for a quiet place to live, if you're looking for true community, and if you're looking for just beauty all around, everywhere you drive on the island, a little bit of inconvenience for all of the benefits that you have. But pick up the phone, give the show a call at 1-855-411-50. Again, it's 1-855-411-50. Or online. Cheryl, what's the best place to get information online about real estate opportunity?
AndersonIslandHomes.com.
AndersonIslandHomes.com. And for rentals, go to AndersonIslandRentals.com. Again, for short term, for the opportunity, if you want to take advantage of the U.S. Open, it's going to be a really great place for you to be able to stay. If you're looking at for some longer term rentals, second home, vacation home, or you're getting ready to retire. Sarah.
I have a website, AndersonIslandRealty.com.
Oh, AndersonIslandRealty.com.
Thank you.
Perfect. So, plenty of resources for you to go to, and I just encourage to take a look at it. And if you haven't heard of Anderson Island, take a trip out there. And I want to say thank you so much for the three of you coming in and spending time in studio, and because it was a little bit of a ways, but a fun trip to take the ferry over. You guys stayed here last night.
Stop by our office. We'll give you a map.
Perfect.
For free.
Yes. You have to charge for the map. Well, thank you so much, you guys, for coming in. I so much appreciate it.
Thank you.
And this is your host and mortgage expert, Tina Mitchell, signing off for the day. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. I will be back here again next week, same time, same place, to talk all about your money. Have a great weekend. Tina Mitchell, right here at 1150 AM KKNW.